Hi, this is Ruben Ganjali. In this video, I'm going to show steps of how to unmount a data store from an ESXi host. Basically, how to fix the error "filesystemisbusy" while unmounting the data store. So please tune in with me and I'm going to show you all about it. Alright, I'm going to log into my ESXi web client interface, doing authentication. Just remember, the username that you want to log in with has to have the full permission. My username is already an admin username. So I'm going to hit the login. There we go. The first step is to migrate or delete all virtual machines out of the data store that you want to unmount. So I'm going to Navigator and try to find virtual machines. Click on virtual machines. Then I try to remove my virtual machines in here. I'm going to right click on it. Then hit the delete. Click on delete. Okay, we just got rid of the virtual machine. The second step is to put the host into the maintenance mode. So I'm going to Navigator, right click on host, then click on enter maintenance mode, click on yes. As you can see, host is in maintenance mode. Right now, if I go back to the Navigator and click on storage, and then right click on my only data store that I have, and then click on unmount, and click on yes, I'll face up some error. I'm waiting for the process bar to see the situation. So it says failed to unmount data store DS0. If I try to take a close look to the error and read it, we will realize what is going on. So, file system is busy. Of course, because DataStore is in use, and the error says cannot unmount volume data store name DS0 with these details, the UID number, this log number is the identity of the data store, because file system is busy. Let's troubleshoot this issue. Actually, the third and the most important step, which is changing the location of some file system from this data store to another place. So in this way, the ESXi is not involved with them anymore and we could be able to unmount our data store. And the name of the location of those file system is scratch partition, which made by ESXi on the data store with the first boot. Let's find where it is. If I go back to the Navigator and click on host, then click on manage. And under the System tab, click on Advanced Settings. Then just type Scratch on the search box. So the result of the search would be the configured Scratch and the current Scratch location. We're going to change the path of both of them. If I edit the first one, I can see the path of the Scratch. So this path is the path that I want to change it to somewhere in the RAM disk as a temporary solution. For doing this, I'm going to get some help from a shell environment. So I go back to the Navigator and right click on host, then select services, then enable SSH. All right, now I try to make a SSH connection with the ESXi host. For doing this, I'm trying to use Mac terminal. But for those people who use Windows operating system, you can use PuTTY. Actually, I have PuTTY here too, but I'm fine with the Mac terminal. So I close the PuTTY and I go back to the terminal. And first I try to make a SSH connection. Type the SSH and the username and the IP address of the host. And typing password. There we go. Let's clear the screen. First, I try to change the current directory to TMP, which is somewhere in the RAM disk. Then I see what's in there. Okay, now I make a directory and I name it Scratch. Let's make sure it's created. Alright, this is the folder I just made. I'm going to copy a command and execute it in terminal. What does this command do is basically change, just let me resize the terminal. If we execute this command, it will change the configure scratch location to the new location that we just made, basically to /tmp/scratch. Okay, if I go back to the web client interface and refresh it, I can see the result. Okay, as you can see, it's there. The path is changed to tmp/scratch. I'm going to copy another command and execute it. The purpose of this command is to repointing the current scratch to the new location. I enter it. Now we're going to restart all running services using the last command. I will execute it and it might take some time. That's it. We're done in shell environment. Now I try to go back to the web client interface. We will see this path is changed. I'll refresh the page. Cool, both of them are changed. So we're good in here. Now I try to go back to the storage section and navigate to DataStore, right click on it and then unmount it. Logically, the DataStore is free right now. So I'm waiting for the process to be done. Okay, we just successfully unmounted. Now I can just go back to the DataStore and right click on it and just delete it. There we go. We just completely got rid of the data store. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please subscribe my channel. Take care.